Hello friends, good morning and welcome to Ashlio's Beagles. Ashlio's Beagles is a place where we love beagles a lot. They're part of our life, they're part of our family. We keep them, we ethically breed them, and we bring quality puppies and we give them to loving homes all over the country. We're known for our integrity, we're known for our ethical way of breeding. We follow the KCI's basic instructions on breeding, and we follow the KCI standards of breeding, and we have happy dogs. So in this video, we would like to give you certain idea about how a whelping box is something that is an instrument that will help you if you decide to breed your dog and you want to have upbring healthy puppies. So a whelping box is a place where the mother gives birth to the pups and upbring the pups for the early days of their life. So let us go on to the video to get more details. This is for the delivery purpose. So if your dog is in labor, you can have her come here to be inside, and so that you can have the delivery done here, or you can even do the delivery done here separately. So once the delivery is done, all the puppies are out, then you can maybe shift them this side. I'll explain to you why it is important to have the mother and the babies in this side. So here we have a plastic slated flooring. It's a perforated flooring with UV coat. What happens here is this particular compartment where if you have the delivery done, mostly the waste, liquid, all that will go down. So you can have a newspaper or a tray down so that it is easy to clean, because the delivery might go on for 12 hours, maybe more, we don't know. So you have to get this cleaned up very often. So you, instead of cleaning often, and if you have something like this, the waste will go down, so that a simple wipe will do. Now you can have a absorbent pad underneath, which maybe if you know that we use it for adults when they are bedridden or something like that. It's like the Pampers kind of a material, but it's like a sheet. So you can have that sheet spread here so that the mother is on that sheet. Any drops of bleeding or anything that will be observed there. So once the delivery is completed, then you can shift the pups and the mother to this particular compartment. Once you shift them here, it is very important that you have a skating like this. It could be done in many ways.
but we prefer to do it in this way, because if you do a plywood skating, then there's less air circulation. In this way, there's more air circulation. Hot country like ours, we need to have a lot of air circulation. That is the reason we have the perforated flooring also. Normally abroad, they use heated pads, and so that the pups and the mother remain warm. But here we need to in fact make them cool, depending on the weather in fact. But in whichever weather, our climate is much warmer than the other countries. They normally they use whelping boxes like this. So this is required for having the puppies safe. What happens when the mother, after giving the birth, she will be very tired. She wants to lie down or something. What happens is her back, if there is a puppy behind her back, then the puppy gets crushed. And most mortality of the puppies happens because of this reason. So if you have this, what happens is the mother's back is rested on the skating, so that the puppy goes underneath and behind. If there is a puppy behind, the puppy will be under this, so the puppy is safe. So there is no harm to the puppy, and the puppy comes out through any ways possible. The puppy is normally in the front of the mother. Normally, mother rests her back on the outside of the whelping box, so any puppy inside will not get harmed. But in case if a puppy is behind her back, then the puppy gets hurt. The puppy might even die. Most cases happens like this.
You may be wondering now why we have two partitions, why we are doing the delivery here and then shifting the pups and mother to this space. This space, as I explained earlier, it is very important that the puppies are as close as possible to mother. So we have a smaller space. This is meant for beagle, so this is just about good enough for the mother to stretch and sleep. So this space, if you have the pups close to the mother, so they are kept warm. The mother's body temperature keeps the puppies warm. Now what happens if you have a larger space, the puppies will move away and they get cold in the night. They might even die. So it's very important that they are very close to mother. So it is not too cramped, it is not too large a space they need to be kept.
So when you have this space just about enough for beagles, if you have another breed of dog, then you need to make it to the measurement of the dog. Probably a larger breed might need the entire space. So that way, this particular design will be enough for the any breed of dog. So that is how this has been designed. Now if you remove the partition in the middle, now this is can be used for even a giant dog and a large breed of dog. And when there is a small breed of dog, then you can use this particular area alone. So this is also very important that you don't keep the puppies and the mother here for a very long period, because once the puppies start grow, about 2 weeks, when they are 2 weeks old, this space is not at all enough. So what happens, you remove the center partition and give them the whole space to run around. You can put in a smaller partition in between, so that the puppies will make their way to the other compartment, which is little harder for them to go. And then they think they started, you can start training them at the young age for toilet, the potty training. Toilet training can be done in this itself. So this is designed in such a way. So even when the pups are growing up, they go toilet here. What happens is the whole thing gets collected down. You can have a tray or a newspaper again, then you remove it. Normally what people do is they put a lot of newspaper inside the whelping box and the area where they keep the puppy. Normally people don't use whelping box, but where they keep the puppies, they put a lot of newspapers. What happens is the newspaper has this ink, the black ink,
get caught on to the puppies. Normally we have beagle breed, they have always white legs and white abdomen. So what happens is the ink of the newspaper gets onto their skin and fur, and they start looking very shabby and ugly. So if you have a perforated flooring, you can have the absorbent sheets here, one or two spread. What happens is the puppies always remain fresh, clean. They are not in contact with any of their waste, urine. So they always remain clean and they have no infection skin issues that comes up. You have very clean and healthy pups will be growing in this. It is also important that they are given a runaround space. So this space is also is good enough for them to move around and run around. We initially shown that how this is being assembled. So when you assemble it, if you remove the center spot, and after the puppies have grown a little bit, they have the capabilities to escape. You can remove the skatings. It's very, very simple and easy to remove the skatings. Once the skatings are removed, this space is good enough for puppies to run around. I will also show you how the center partition is removed and how does it look like. So that is how it looks like. The whole area is now opened up for the puppies. One small change you need to do is you need to remove this center support and then reverse it so that the puppy doesn't get hurt at all here. You can do everything the same way with the other partitions also, so the puppies are safe. Now for the mother to move around, you can initially have a smaller a doorway so that only the mother can move inside and outside, the puppies cannot move. As the puppies grow, you can add more height to the entrance doorway. The entrance doorway has more height, so the puppies cannot climb out. It has a nice beading, so there is no sharp edges, all the sharp edges are being buffed and grind, and so you have no sharp edges. So it's a clean, good whelping box. You know, even abroad we don't have a very good whelping box like this. It's well thought of and well designed. Yeah, we just wanted to show you, you know, the whelping box and the size of it versus the beagle dog. So this is this is the exact size. So in video normally you don't get to see the exact size. So she can climb through a partition, that a small step that we made. In fact, this step is the same box we use for feeding the puppies, which I will show you. Gia wants to go. You can see even when they are pregnant, they can move around. You need to slightly assist when they are fully pregnant. In fact, you also need to have them here for at least a week or two before delivery date, so that they get really used to a whelping box like this. The step is the same thing that turns around to be the puppy feeding box. So it's multi-purpose. So friends, I hope you enjoyed the video and you got to know a little bit about how a whelping box is made, designed and made. We have designed it on our own and we have made it in-house. Of course, it is not always possible for everyone to make it on their own. Anybody would like to know how this is made, we are very happy to share the information and the design and everything for somebody to make it on their own. If somebody would like this to be made for them, for their size of dog, we are very happy to make it also. This is, as you've seen in the Tang Labs video, it's a very simple, transportable equipment. You can completely dismantle piece by piece, and it can be transported anywhere very easily. And also, once this is not in use, you can have this completely packed, removed, everything can be removed, and it could be packed, it could be kept in some corner or a storeroom in your home, absolutely with no trouble. Please do let us know what you think of this. Please like us, comment us. We are not a very commercial YouTube blogger or a channel. We just do this only for people to know how things are evolving, what are the new things that are coming into this kind of hobby. Now, we are not a breeder, we are not a commercial breeder where we breed puppies to sell. We are very happy to have dogs and puppies with us. We love them a lot. Our dogs are part of our family, so we want to give them the most comfort possible in this kind of environment and this part of the world. We also would love to help people who would like to keep their dogs happy and give them best of facilities. We would be very happy and glad to talk to them. We really don't want to talk to or encourage commercial breeding. We don't want to help commercial breeders who come to us just to know things or to approach us for puppies only for breeding purpose. No, we don't like them. We don't want to talk to them. We really wanted to keep in touch with those who are ethical breeders, who breed with the KCA, KCI standards, take care of their dogs, love the dogs, give them good food, give them good kind of environment to live, and most importantly, if you want to breed, breed it for hobby, which means like once in a year, and 3 or 4 times maximum in their lifespan is what we need to breed them. So if those kind, if you are that kind, please do keep in touch with us. We have our own Facebook page, we have our own WhatsApp group. We'll be very happy to have you there, share informations, share ideas, and mutually help each other in whichever way possible. We'll be really glad to keep in touch with you. Thank you very much.